Hello, my dear children. This is your computer teacher. Today in computers, we will start chapter 2, that is working in Windows 7. So, let's get started. First of all, what is Windows? Windows is an operating system. This was launched by Microsoft Company in 2009. Windows has so many features. We will discuss about few features today. First of all, start with Windows Explorer. Windows Explorer enables us to display directory structure that includes drives, folders and files. Means, using the Windows Explorer, we can see all kinds of files and folders and drives which are in our computer. So, let's see how to start Windows Explorer. You have to come on the start button, right click here and here you can see open Windows Explorer. This way, we have to click on this and we will open Windows Explorer. This you can see, this is the window of Windows Explorer. Here you can see these are the libraries. These all are the libraries of the computer. Here you can create your own library using this. You have to click on new library and here you can write the name of the library, suppose new, and then enter. This way you can create the new library. These are the libraries in which you can keep your folders and files. At the left side, you will see all the contents of your computer are shown. Here you can see all the drives of computer, computer C drive, D drive, E drive, network, libraries, documents, everything is shown here. Okay? And the right side, you will see these libraries. You can create your own library and you can put your folder inside this library. How to put the folder? Just click on the library and you can see include a folder. Click on this option. And you can include whatever you want to include in this library. Suppose I want to include this downloads. There is no option, there is no file in the downloads. So let's take another. Suppose this is also empty. So right now I'm not having any file in my computer since I have formatted this. So if you want to include any file, then you have to click on this include folder and then you will take the file and then you will click on include folder option. Okay, and your file or folder will be included here. So this way we can create the libraries. Now let us see this computer folder. In this computer folder you can see you are viewing the extra large icons. Here at the right side you can see this arrow. You have to click on this more options. And these are the options to view the content of these files. You can take extra large icons. Then these things will be shown as extra large. If you click again and then take large icons, then these are shown in extra large way. If you take medium icons, then this is the view of medium icons. If you click on small icons, then you can see this is the small icons. If you take list, these all things will be shown as a list. If you click on details, then details are also displayed. But this is 1494 GB, this is 195 GB. Okay, if you click on this tiles, then you will see this way this will be shown. And if you click on content, then this way it will be shown. Okay, so these are the view options available in your computer to see the icons. Normally we choose the tiles option. Okay, so this way we can see the contents of the whole computer. The next thing is control panel. So what is control panel? As in your mobile, you use setting option to change the setting of your mobile. In the same way, in computers we use control panel to change the setting of the computer. So how to open the control panel? Click on the start button. Here you can see control panel. From here we can open, or in this computer folder also there is an option of open control panel. Click on this and you can see this is the settings inside the control panel. These all settings we can change. Here you can see view by small icons and large icons. Two categories are there. If we click on large icons, then only few things are displayed. And if we click on small icons, then you can see so many settings are displayed. Suppose now we want to change the date and time of the computer, then how to change it? You have to click on this date and time option inside this control panel. Click on this. You can see here, you can see the option of change date and time. Click on this. From here we can take any date which we want, and from here we can take the time which we want, and then click on OK. Okay, and change time zone also. You can take the time zone from where you are living. Suppose you are living in Canada or in India, wherever you are living, you can take the country, and then accordingly you can set the time zone of that country. Okay, so this is the way to change the date and time setting of your computer. Now the next thing is hibernation. What is hibernation? Hibernation is a state in which a computer shuts down to save power, but first saves everything in the memory on hard disk. When we restart the computer, our desktop is restored in the same way as we left it. Means our power is saved. If we hibernate the computer, then it shuts down, but it saves everything. When we restart it, we find the computer same as we left. Okay, you can see here, if we click on the start button and then this arrow, you can see there is an option of hibernate. Okay, if we click on hibernate, then our computer will restart in the same way as we have left it. Now let's see how to change the hibernate setting. You have to open the control panel. Then here you can see there is an option of power options. Click on this power options. Here you will click on change when to turn off the display. Click on this, change advanced power setting. Here you have to click on sleep, hibernate after, and here you can change the minutes, that if you leave the computer, then when it sleeps, then how much time you want that it should hibernate. Okay, this way you can make your computer to save your power. Okay, this way it will save the power and your battery will be lasting longer. Okay, now let's see another thing, that is control panel home. Here we will see there is an option of fonts. Click on this fonts. Then you will see here all kinds of fonts which are available in your computer. You can see these are the fonts available in our computer. If we want to add more fonts, we can add more fonts here. Okay, we have to get the fonts and copy them in this folder. Okay, you can see change font size, you can change the size of the fonts, and so many options are available for the fonts here. So this way we can change the font setting. And if we want to change the mouse setting, then also there is an option to change the mouse setting. Here you can see there is an option of mouse. Click on this mouse and you can switch primary and secondary button. Next thing is double click speed. You want slow or fast. Next is click lock. Turn on click lock. Pointer, you can change the way you want the pointer. There are so many options to change the pointer. Pointer options are available. Pointer speed and display pointer tail. You can see here, tails will be same. Wheel and hard wheel. So from here we can change the setting of the mouse. So children, this much for today. This chapter is complete today. Thank you. Bye-bye.